Hello again, Bob Stockberger, pastor of Life Point Giles. Welcome to our midweek devotion. Today we're going to start a six-part series answering this question. Why did God allow this to happen? We have all had things in our lives that have traumatized us. And one of the first questions that comes to our mind when these things happen, Lord, why? Why me? Why is this happening? And when you look at the statistics of people who are non-believers, the number one reason they don't believe is because they don't think God is fair. Why did you allow this hurricane? Why did you allow this tornado? Why did my mom have to die of cancer? Why did I have a heart attack? That is the number one question people struggle with. And when they refuse to believe in God, that's the main reason they do. There are other reasons, but that is one of the most important. So we're going to spend some time on this very, very interesting and deep question. I had a dear lady who asked me this question many years ago. I'll call her name Linda. That is not her name. And Linda was in my office and was sobbing. And I went in and asked what was going on, and she just burst out, why did God let this happen to my son? She and her husband had just taken their son to a university in another state, and the very next week, while jogging around this middle part of the campus, was run over by another student who was drunk. And he was killed. And she was sobbing. Why did God allow this to happen? So that's the theme. And we're going to start with the very first part of this question by looking at who God is. When we look at Genesis, we look at creation. After every day's creation, God said, and it was good. All of his creation, that it was good. And then when he created man, after that day, he said it was very good. Now, this is important. Very good, there's no Hebrew word for very. In the Hebrew text, is tov-tov. It's good, good, okay? And what that means is that double expression, anytime God doubles words in the Bible, he's saying, pay attention. Truly, truly, I say to you, truly, truly, you better be listening. Jesus is telling you something important. He said creation was good, good. Perfect. Really good. That is God's character. God is good. His creation was good. And his plan and design for man and woman in that creation was good. We'll see a little later how that got messed up and how that has led to a fallen creation, which we still live in to this day. But God gets blamed for many, many things that he does not do. God is defined. God is love in 1 John. That's a definition of God. He is love. He cares about you. He cares about me. And so my first gentle answer to that question, after I had hugged this dear lady and shed tears with her, and I said, I can't understand this grief. I've never lost a child, but I know this has to be the most horrible time of your life. And I just was crying with her and hugging her. And then I said, but I know one thing. God loves you. And God would never cause something evil like this to happen to your son. God loves you. And that's where we begin. When we answer this question, God in his nature is perfect. He is the perfect judge. He makes perfect decisions. He never does anything that is wrong. He never tempts you into sin. He never causes you to have torture or pain or suffering. God loves you. He cares for you. And He is there with you during your horrible grief. When you're struggling with, you may have had a child who was killed or a child who's had a serious accident and is disabled. I even had a dear patient in her early 80s weeping, said, over her 65-year-old son, who was a grown man, a retired man, who had cancer. I wish my Johnny could have I could have his cancer so he could live and I could die. That is our normal response as parents. Absolutely. When our children are hurting, we want to take that burden on us. So that is normal. And this dear mother was just sobbing because the grief was unbearable. But God loves. God did not bring about this horrible death of her son. God loves her. He loves me. And He loves you. And His plan in our lives is perfect. He has a design for us. He has a place for us. He has gifts and talents He's given us that He wants us to use for His glory. God is love, and He is perfect. And that's where we begin this journey. And why did God allow this to happen? Part one. I hope you enjoy this series as we explore this question very deeply. And I pray that you will get some answers that you may have been searching for. And we're going to use God's word to guide us through this study, which is difficult. But God will bless it. Let's pray together. Father God, horrible things happen to many people all over the world, all the time. We just see tragedies, and our heart goes out for those who have lost loved ones or whose loved ones are hostages or have been kidnapped or murdered. All things just go on in this world that make us weep. And we weep with those who are suffering. But God, we turn to You because You love us. You are there for us. You comfort us. You had to weep. You had to turn Your back on Your very Son as He cried out on the cross He was nailed to. Father, Father, why have You forsaken Me? You had to turn Your back and let Him die. So 3 days later, You could raise Him up from death to forgive our sins, to give us eternal life, to give us that perfect relationship with You. Father, thank You for Your love that You gave Yourself by giving Your very Son to die a horrible, painful death for me, for all of us. Father God, thank You for being a loving God. In Your holy name I pray. Amen. If you've enjoyed this devotion, please like it, subscribe, follow it, turn on the little bell so you'll get a ding-ding or a little message when we have a new video posted. Share it with your friends and family on your Facebook page, on your contact list. And if you don't have a church home, oh, we'd love to have you visit Life Point Giles, 600 Tazewell Street, right in the heart of Parrisburg. We worship at 11:15 every Sunday. 10:15, we have Sunday school. Love to have you join us. God bless you and have a wonderful week.